Hey guys, Murkeebs here, and in this video, I'll be checking out the V75 Plus, a pretty compelling barebones kit from Sea-Doo. As usual, quick disclaimer, this video was not sponsored, but EpoMaker did graciously send the unit over for an honest review. But as usual, all thoughts and opinions about the product are always my own. Alright, so jumping right into it, the Sea-Doo V75 Plus is an in-stock barebones kit available straight from EpoMaker's website priced at $133.99. As of recording this video, the colorway that I'll be featuring, the Retro Gray, has since been phased out and Sea-Doo has ceased production on it. But the board is still readily available in its moon white colorway. Now for the unboxing. Opening up the box, you get the board itself, the user manual, a thin layer of case foam, a straight braided USB Type-C to Type-A cable, a set of screw-in stabilizers enough to cover the board, a combo switch and keycap puller, a hex key, and some pour-on gaskets that you'll need to install yourself later on during the build. Now let's take a look at the main casing. The case shares the same design language as Sea-Doo's other boards, like the V65 and V87. The layout here is a standard non-exploded 75% layout with a customizable screen on the top right side of the board. Over on the right side next to the arrow keys, there's a case badge with a weird-looking panther logo for some reason that also doubles as storage for the 2.4GHz wireless dongle. Here's a quick look at the side profile. Pretty simple looking without anything flashy or standing out. Just a gap in the bottom case for you to easily move the board around if need be. Underneath the board there are holes for 6 hex screws, 4 small case feet, and a reflective Sea-Doo case badge in the bottom. You're not really going to be finding any external weights or anything, all that's there is just these ridges to give the bottom a bit more of an interesting look. Over on the back of the case, on the left side you'll find the USB-C port and the wireless on and off toggle switch. Depending on how the switch is placed, it turns the board over to different modes. When the switch is on the center, it's in wired mode, on the left it connects to the dongle, and on the right it goes to Bluetooth mode. Now for software customizability, for messing with the board functions and features, the board is VIA compatible with the JSON file available to download from Sea-Doo or EpoMaker's website. Super handy for messing with key mappings, layer functions, lighting, and macro keys. Then to customize your screen, Sea-Doo also provides a software for uploading pictures or GIFs. Pretty bare bones, but it's a nice novelty for adding a bit of personality to your build. Now to get the board open, I'll be taking off the 6 hex screws underneath the board to get the top case off. The provided hex key is really useful for this as the holes on top of the board are a bit more sunken in. So most precision screwdrivers won't be much use aside from the 3 holes in the bottom. Then once the top case is off, be sure to disconnect the attached daughter board, battery cable, and connector for the screen before messing with anything. Now before I get building, here's a look at what comes inside the assembly. First you get a polycarbonate plate, then some pour-on plate foam, some IX-PE foam, and the PCB. The PCB is south-facing, hot-swappable with Kale hot-swap sockets, has a lot of flex cuts, plate standoffs, and a stuck-on plastic layer which I'll be taking off for the build. Then stuck underneath the PCB is a layer of rear PCB foam. Then inside the bottom case you'll find the daughter board, a 3000mAh battery, and the screen attached to the casing. Then lastly, all along the case you'll find these little silicone pads that act as a force brake mod to stop the board from sounding pingy with metal and metal contact. And that's it for the overview. Now for the build. First, I'll be disassembling and lubing all of the included stabilizers, then installing them onto the PCB. Then I'll be installing the PE foam, but for the sound test later, I'll also be doing a test without it installed. Next comes the plate foam, and finally the polycarbonate plate to finish off the plate assembly. Now for my switches, EpoMaker also sent over these Sea-Doo Mint Linear switches. These are a 5-pin factory lube linear switch, with a full PA66 nylon housing, a long pole palm stem, and has a 20mm long spring. The switch has an actuation of 43 grams and bottoms out at 56 grams. With the switch having a pre-travel of 1.8mm and a total travel of 3.9mm. In my testing so far, these switches are super smooth and lean towards a very poppy sound signature. Then as mentioned earlier, you'll need to install these pour-on gaskets that came with the kit. They come in 2 sizes, so you'll need to make sure to install the thicker ones inside the bottom case, while the thinner ones go inside the top case. Then, after all that's done and the board is closed up, all that's left is to place the keycaps. I'll be using GMK Villanelle. Now I'll be leaving you guys with the typing test for the finished build in both a PE foamed and non-PE foamed config. All details for the build will be listed on screen, then I'll give my overall thoughts on the board right after. Alright, so I'll keep my final thoughts short because I don't really have a lot of complaints. There's a lot to like here. The board sounds and feels pretty nice. And for its price of $133.99, Sidoo is offering a good value product, plain and simple. Whether PE foamed or non-PE foamed, the board sounds nice and poppy with still a decent amount of bounce even when fully foamed up because of the flex cuts. When it comes to ease of building, this isn't at all complicated to put together at all. Just lube and tune your stabilizers, put your plate assembly together, and install the pour-on gaskets all around the case, and that's pretty much it. No fuss, no muss. My only real complaint is one aspect of the board's aesthetics. The Panther logo on the case badge and storage compartment kind of sticks out, and I'm not sure why it's even there in the first place. But thankfully for the other variant of this board, Sidoo have kept it simple with a simple and minimalist blank case badge. So if you're a fan of how the board looks, how it sounds, and how simple it is to put together, then I can happily recommend this board. So with that being said, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment and drop a like, as these videos take a lot of work. And if you want to see more content just like this, please consider subscribing. It would really mean a lot. Thanks to EpoMaker for sending this board out for review, and all relevant links on where to get your hands on this board will be in the video description down below. Thank you guys for watching. Till next time. Merkeebs out.